गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर स्टडिंग द चैप्टर द मॉडर्न डायनेस्टी. सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस चैप्टर टिल हेयर वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द मॉडर्न एम्पायर, दैट द फर्स्ट रूलर वॉज चंद्रगुप्त मौर्य. ही वॉज असिस्टेड बाय चाणक्य, हु वॉज हिज गुरु एंड हिज प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑल्सो. देन वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट बिंदुसार, ही वॉज द सन ऑफ चंद्रगुप्ता. देन वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट अशोका, ही वॉज अ ग्रेट ruler and you know he is being counted one of the world's best ruler, and his life changed after the war of Kalinga. So that was a great turning point. Now we will study afterlife, after the war of Kalinga, what kind of life he was living. Then he adopted Buddhism after the Kalinga war and spent the rest of his life in propagating and preaching it. You know, Ashoka was so moved from the sight of war, from the cries, from the dead bodies. He was so moved that he adopted Buddhism and he spent rest of his life in propagating and preaching it. Propagating means in spreading the Buddhism, in spreading this religion, and he taught people about it, not only in India but also in many other countries of the world. So he taught about, he spread the religion, Buddhism, not only in India but in the other countries of the world also. He advised his sons and grandsons not to conquer new countries. So he gave the advice not to conquer new countries, not to take up wars, but to take care of the territory they had. They were advised to go in for dharm vijay, winning the hearts of the people. So winning the new countries is not a good idea. Instead of that, you must learn to win the hearts of the people. That he taught to his sons and grandsons. Ashoka got his teachings engraved on rocks and stone pillars in local language like Kharoshthi, Prakrit, Greek and Aramaic. So his teachings, whatever he taught to the people, whatever he taught to his sons, grandsons, that is engraved on rocks and stones, pillars in language like Kharoshthi, Prakrit, Greek and Aramaic. These teachings are known as his edicts. So these are known as his edicts. Fine. If the question comes, what are edicts? The teaching of Ashoka that are engraved on rock, pillars and stones. Ashoka's Buddhism or Dham, a Prakrit word for the Sanskrit term dharma, which means moral values. So Ashoka's Buddhism or dham, that means dharm in Sanskrit language, is a little different from classical Buddhism. So what the basic Buddhism tells us, Ashoka's preachings are a little bit different from them. Two main features of Ashoka's dhammas related to social and ethical code of conduct are, so there are two main features of Ashoka's dharma, what he preached about Buddhism. So two main features. Feature number one, everybody should serve parents, care and love all living creatures and animals. So his preachings has many points, means everyone should take care of their parents, and we must show love and care to all living creatures and animals. Follow and adopt the path of truth. We should always follow the path of truth. Be kind to slaves, servants and workers. So if we have servants, workers, slaves, so we must not be cruel to them. We must show our kindness to them also. Respect all elders, whether they are our parents, whether they are anyone. If they are elder, so they are subject to respect. Elders, Brahmin, teachers, monks, so sabki respect karo. Follow non-violence. Non-violence means non-aggressive way. Shanti se har cheez solve karo, jisme ladai jhagda na ho kuch bhi. Have tolerance and peace. वन शुड हैव अ पावर टू टॉलरेट थिंग्स. ठीक है, सहना भी आना चाहिए, बियर करना भी आना चाहिए, एंड पीस. देन एवरीबडी शुड अवॉइड एरोगेंस, एनिमिटी, सेक्रीफाइस ऑफ एनिमल, फाइटिंग फॉर रिलीजन एंड लैंड. सो दीज थिंग्स शुड बी अवॉइडेड. एरोगेंस, एरोगेंट नहीं होना चाहिए हमको बिल्कुल भी. ठीक है, एनिमिटी, दुश्मन वाली फीलिंग नहीं होनी चाहिए. एनिमल्स को मारना नहीं चाहिए, जैसे बोलते हैं ना सेक्रीफाइस देना है, बलि देनी है, नो दैट शुड नॉट बी देयर. एंड वी मस्ट नॉट फाइट फॉर अवर रिलीजन एंड लैंड. ही वॉन्टेड दैट हिज पीपल शुड लिव इन हारमनी विद ईच अदर. सो वॉट ही वॉन्टेड दैट हिज पीपल विल लिव विद ईच अदर विद अ लॉट ऑफ लव, विद अ लॉट ऑफ पीस. He subjected and patronized all religions. So he respected it. You know, he was following Buddhism, but it was not like that he did not allow other religions. He allowed every religion, whatever you want to follow. And he take care of those religions also. Ashoka's state was really a welfare state. So you know his territory was a very nice territory, welfare वहाँ लोगों का होता था. He treated his people as a father would treat his children. So for him, his people were like his children. He gave maximum facilities to the people. So he tried to give a lot of facilities to the people. Trees were planted on both sides of the roads. Wells were dug, hospitals for people and animals were opened, orphanages for and old age homes were established during his life. You know, he had done so much work. Trees, he planted trees on both sides of the road for shade. Then wells were there so that people would not have scarcity of water. Hospitals were there for people as well as for the animals also. Even orphanages, anath ashrams were also there. And he appointed Dhamma Mahamata, who went from place to place teaching people about Dhamma. So he appointed people who used to go to one place, from one place to another place, to teach about his Dharma. Now administration, what kind of administration was there? Rule chalta kaise tha? So the Mauryan administration was run under the guidance of Chanakya. So the thing is that Chanakya was the main person jiski guidelines ke according Mauryan empire chalti thi. The king was the head of the state and enjoyed supreme powers of military, judiciary and civil administration. So king, he was the head of the state and all the powers were in his hands, whether that was military, whether that was judiciary. Judiciary means justice karne ki power, and civil administration, logon pe kis tarah raj karna, everything was in the hands of the king. He had a mantri parishad, that was council of ministers, to advise and assist him. So he had a lot of ministers also, that was known as mantri parishad, and they used to advise him and help him in his work. However, the king was not bound to follow their advice. You know, there wasn't any foundation कि अगर उन्होंने कोई डिसीजन सुना दिया तो किंग भी वही फॉलो करेगा. नो, देवर जस्ट सजेशंस. इट वॉज अप टू द किंग कि उन सजेशंस को माने या ना माने. द मिनिस्टर्स वर अपॉइंटेड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ मेरिट. ही कैप्ट लेडीज एज हिज बॉडी गार्ड्स. अमात्या, महामात्रा, अध्यक्षा, पुरोहित, सेनापति, युवराज वर सम ऑफ द ऑफिशियल्स इन हिज कोर्ट. दीज आर द नेम्स ऑफ द ऑफिशियल्स देवर इन हिज कोर्ट. There was a very efficient espionage system. Espionage system means activity of spying. You know, spies were also there. Guptachar bolte the us time pe unko. The whole empire was divided into smaller units for efficient administration. So the whole empire, they have divided. Jaise hamari itni badi country hai, that is also divided into different states for proper administration. Likewise, his state was also divided into small parts. The city administration was under Nagaradhyaksh or Nagrik, like mayor. You know, at that time, जो city है उसकी administration, उसका rule किसने देखना है? Nagaradhyaksh, जैसे आजकल mayor होते हैं. He was helped by 30 members, जैसे हमारे ward members होते हैं ना, likewise 30 members. दे वर डिवाइडेड इंटू सिक्स बोर्ड्स ऑफ फाइव मेंबर्स. सो सिक्स बोर्ड्स थे, हर सिक्स बोर्ड में फाइव फाइव मेंबर्स थे. ईच बोर्ड वॉज असाइंड डिफरेंट ड्यूटीज टू बी परफॉर्म्ड. सो यू नो सिक्स बोर्ड्स वर देयर बट ईच बोर्ड हैज़ इट्स ओन ड्यूटी. कोई वाटर सप्लाई देख रहा है, कोई कुछ और देख रहा है, प्लांटिंग ऑफ ट्रीज देख रहा है, यू नो द वर्क वॉज डिवाइडेड. The village administration was run by a group of officers. They kept record of the people, collected taxes and maintained law and order in their village. So village administration, that was also there. Group of officers were there. They used to keep the record. They collected taxes and they maintained law and order in the village. They used to take care of the law and order of the village. So students, up to here only we will study today. And in the next video, we will take up the rest of the chapter. So, revise your chapter thoroughly. Thank you, students. Have a nice day.